I don't know about you, but I'm pretty much ready for the fall. I'm ready for the fall. Freaking tunas, it might be this one, right? Either that or the temperature's freaking whacking out. So I pulled I pulled the scratch plate off. I think I like it better. The thing with the scratch plate was it's just a different cream. It's like it's like the other ones are cream, and this is like eggshell. Pretty much looks like it's eggshell, and it doesn't really match, right? So it looks white. Yeah, it looks a little off, and so it looks better with it off. I don't know. What do you think? Better with it off? Show of hands. Show of hands. So, as I've said before, thank you for all you guys, for freaking Robert, all you guys, struggling guitarists, and all you guys, freaking that Billy, freaking commenting on the goddamn videos and stuff like that. And none of them are showing up in the notifications. I don't know what the flip that's all about. I really don't. I really don't know what the hell that's all about. I mean, that's kind of weird. I mean, and so I had to go back, literally. I went back about, I don't know, 5 days. I put up a lot of videos. I'm prolific. What can I tell you? And all the comments were there. And I'm like, God damn, man. How the hell? So if I didn't get to you or I don't respond, man, it's not because I didn't, you know, I'm ignoring you or anything like that. God forbid. I mean, It's that I just didn't show up. I'd show you notifications, but I don't. Once I set that camera, it's a freaking blip to reset it. So. And then I don't know about you. How are you with the shaky cam? I'm finding as I get older, I can't handle the shaky cam at all. I get freaking, what do you call that shit? I didn't know what to call high anxiety. It's not high anxiety. It's, what the hell do they call it? There's a freaking word. There's a word for it, and I can't remember what the hell it is. And, but I get ill. I get, like, motion sickness when I see the freaking shaky cam. And I can't even look at it through the side of my freaking eyeballs. It's still, like, freaking crazy. Like, dude, stop. Please, stop. Just stabilize. Put the freaking auto stabilizer on there or some shit. Because it messes with my head. It just messes with my head. One good thing about having the fans on is you can't hear the computer fan as well. It's there, you can hear it, but it's not as pronounced. Horrible. So, yeah, and this is the one I already sprayed. So, it's gotta be the capacitors or the freaking pots themselves just need to be freaking replaced and put in better pots. But otherwise, this puppy is nice. You know what I found on the freaking bed? I'm like, what? How the hell am I like? Can you see? What? I have absolutely no reason. I don't like wear shirts or anything like that. So why is there a pin in my freaking bed? I must not have put that freaking that doll away. I don't know if it's a video or what, but I was saying in the other video, the last one I put up, I was like, you know, I don't do freaking, was the last one? I can't remember, because I do the videos, but I don't post them up right away. But, oh yeah, metal. Sometimes you just... I love metal. Don't get me wrong. I love metal. I love me some metal. I love all of that shit. Freaking, you know. I went to go see Megadeth, and I saw Megadeth at the Savoy. I saw Metallica in Long Island. Not the Coliseum, but actually on... name of the beach, not Long Beach, freaking Jones Beach. I saw them at Jones Beach. They were great. I don't know, what are your thoughts on Kirk Hammett, man? I'm like, how the hell is this fucking no talent? I can't say that. He probably plays about as good as me, you know. Seriously, I don't think there's much Seriously. And that's kind of scary if you think about it. But the other guy, freaking Hetfield. Hetfield is freaking everything. I mean, he's everything. I mean, without Hetfield, there is no freaking Metallica, right? Seriously. Because he's got a lot of talent. I mean, he's just got a lot of talent. He freaking bangs shit out. He works on licks all the freaking time and everything like that. And, you know, when it comes to shit like that, I don't know what the fuck happened with Kirk. He's saying that, Kirk was saying shit like freaking, oh yeah, the guy from Scorpions, the freaking Michael Schenker, he was my idol growing up and everything like that. And he was like, well, Schenker was a lot of guitarist idol, but, you know. But he's got a long way to go. I mean, well, Schenker was also freaking like a prodigy. He really was. I mean, from what I understand, as far as the story and everything is concerned, and how other people were freaking, you know, looking at how he was playing and everything like that. It was like this. There's something not natural about, you know, the way he plays, because he was coming up with shit that's just freaking beyond. And at the time, I mean, he was almost like almost neoclassical before freaking Yngwie freaking walked in. You know, he was everything before, he was right up there with, what's his name, with Blackmore, as far as proficiency and technique and everything like that. Yeah, he fucking rocked. But it's just like everything else, you know. You got like that 4 minute mile, you know. Once you get the freaking 4 minute mile, everybody can freaking break a 4 minute mile then. That's why I was getting frustrated, you know. That's why I was getting frustrated the other day. I had the capo on and I started playing Jelly Roll, and I'm like, you know, at first it was really intimidating. I think that's what it was. It was just really fucking intimidating, and I just couldn't. And I knew it was just an easy freaking pattern. It is. It's just an easy freaking pattern. It's like, you know, there's nothing different about it than I would have done for anything else, really. Keep hitting the mic. Oh, that's really off. And, that sounded good, eh? Because all it is a bunch of pull-offs. See, all it is a bunch of pull-offs. Open A, and you pull this one off. Then you pull off the next one, one string up, two frets over. Open, pull off again. Nope, sorry. But then it got to go from that to this. That's where I'm having a hiccup. I'm having a brain fart every time that freaking I get into that. But once I get past that, then I can be fluid, because everything else is pretty fluid. It's just a normal blues rhythm. And then it goes to this inverted D, that D shape, inverted D shape, that freaking, that's not played like a normal strum, but picked on an up pick. In rhythm. And then it's an E shape. An E shape to a G shape. To a D shape. To a C shape. Back to an A minor shape. Back to an A shape. And that's it, you know? I mean, that's it. There's something later on that he does. And I don't know the lead, but he does something up there at some point after a chorus. I think it's a couple of measures in. But I have not got to that part yet. But it's not hard. It's just a lot of freaking repetition. You gotta freaking over and over and over again. That's it. And you just do it over and over and over again. And it sounds good. So, just gotta do it over and over and over again in order for it to sound like a regular freaking song, you know? So, that's that. I mean, I think that's kind of cool. I don't know, have any of you guys checked out that Randy Schardiger? I haven't checked out any of his, like, you know, his tutorials or anything like that, but I like that. That's why I picked this up, because it's a heavy picking. And I just need to work on that, because that really freaking, to me, it's like the next best thing to finger picking. Because you can get a lot of freaking nice melodies and shit like that if you get your picking patterns freaking slamming. And I think you can get away with a lot of crap personally when you start finger picking, because you cover a lot of ground in a little amount of space, and it just brings such a full sound of the guitar out that, you know, you just sit there. I don't know. There's this guy Adrian Legg. Adrian Legg with two G's, and he does some finger picking stuff that just is mind boggling. And he'll sit there and he'll be tuning, he'll play with the freaking tuning while he's playing, and it's just, you know, he's doing all kinds of dive bombs and stuff like that, and it's wild to freaking watch him play live. But he's awesome. He's got the one album I picked up, it's called Cathedrals. And I love it. I mean, I really do. I don't think I could never touch it at this point. None of it. Not one freaking part of it. And that's okay. You know, that's like the saying. You know, I'm not where I want to be, but, you know, I guess I'm right where I'm supposed to be. So it's all good. All right. Picking it up again. So, my best wishes to you, my brother, and I hope your freaking collarbone feels better. And took a roll. This guy's like, he's 5 years younger than me, so he's like, what, 47? He gets on a goddamn skateboard, decides he's gonna go downhill. Oh, but I was wearing a helmet. It's like, what the hell would possess you to get on one of those goddamn things to begin with? He says he went to go take a roll. He jumped off because it was wobbling out of control. So he jumped off. Okay, so he jumped off. He jumps off and he lands. Instead of doing a full roll, he hits his shoulder. And then he rolls. So his collarbone went poof. showed a picture of it. So he showed me a picture of it. So he's showing it to me for, like, from the back. And from the back, you could see this thing going up like this. I'm like, that's gotta fucking hurt, man. So he's like, yeah, no good guitar for me, man. And this is the one that was wanting, you know, to get the Gretsch, right? He was gonna sell all his shit to get the Gretsch. I'm exaggerating, but it was getting down to that freaking point. Gretsch is what? The Gretsch is like freaking a decent used one, right? It's like freaking $700. And, but he's a lefty. So, of course, you know, they'll freaking spike him for everything they're worth. So they're looking at like 12. I mean, he was looking at one for like, I think he found one for like 750. If I'm not correct. Yeah, about 750 and stuff. So, I think I mentioned it in one of the last videos, and you're like, oh yeah, that's a great fucking, that's a great price. I'm like, whew. That's a heavy hit. So, I think I'm going to save my pennies and not get anything and get a Fender Twin or a Hot Rod. It's between those two. It's between the Twin and the Hot Rod. I have to play them side by side, you know. I seen one that's not so bad. There's a Deluxe Deville. Hot Rod Deluxe Deville. And it's a 2. So it's tall, you know. It's not... I like them low, you know. I like them low. I like the small jam. I don't know. But, I was thinking, I was wanting to get a freaking Vibralux, but those things are freaking definitely, you know, it's above 1,000. Easily, even used. So, and only because, what's his name? That's the only thing he used to play. What's his name? As in... Who's the gentleman? A lot of people... Oh, it'll come to me. Give me a minute. I can't remember his goddamn name now. Roy Buchanan. I'm sorry. That's Roy Buchanan. Did you see the... There's a documentary. On Roy Buchanan. And so that was the one... When I saw him and he was playing at his family's house, that's what he had. He had a Vibralux. And I was saying, well, I'll get either one of those or a freaking 68. I saw a side-by-side between a 68 reissue and a 65 reissue, reverb reissue. And, the 68 definitely won, in my opinion, you know, listening to it, I just thought it was a better unit. So, and then, like an idiot, I'm thinking, but the tweed looks so awesome. Why? Because Monomassa has freaking tons of tweeds, right? Monomassa has tons of tweeds. And I'm like, but that's not the point, Dan. The point is whether you love the sound or not. And I played a Twin with the red knobs over at Music Go Round. They had a nice selection of Twins. They're all like $600-$700, but they had a nice selection of Twins over there, and the reverb reissue. So I don't know. They all sounded great. I mean, they all sounded great. I think the Twin with the red knobs was my least favorite. Most affordable, but least favorite. So I think I'm gonna, I guess I gotta play them some more and then just, you know, say, well, you know what, even though it's the least affordable, that's the one I'm not going to get, because it's about, you know, being the most desired, right? Because that's the one that's going to keep you freaking, keep you inspired to play more, or to play it more. Just like this thing, you know, it was just, I was like, I miss it. I can't not play it. Because when it does sound good, it does sound good. When it sounds like crap, it just sounds like crap. But like this, I mean, it's just, it's unbelievable. But if it's a piece of shit, then it's not going to inspire me to freaking play it anymore. You know what I mean? And there are, I do have one, and I have it in pieces at the moment. That's the one that was really freaking heavy. That's the backs on, and I'm still working on the getting the balls up to freaking take the goddamn neck apart, so I can fix the warp on it. And it is warped badly. And I have to fix the warp, and I have to replace the truss rod, because the truss rod just is gone. It's gone. And so, but the neck is like freaking teeny tiny. Like, it's definitely not 2 inches. It's almost like, you know, an inch and three quarters over here, and then it's like freaking really thin over here. So I'm like, no, I put it downstairs, it's in the shop. So I don't know, it's gonna take me a little while to get that freaking puppy done, and then I want to do it while retaining the frets for any particular reason. I just want to do it to see if I can do it without removing the frets. Because the frets were okay, if I remember correctly. But that's the one I put the Les Paul Special. Good Lord. I put the Les Paul Special freaking neck on there with the D profile, right? With the D profile. And I had the GFS fat pats on there, and the tone was just fucking phenomenal. I mean, but it weighed a ton. I mean, it weighed a ton, and no, it just weighed a ton. I think I was telling somebody in the comments, you know, I'm ready to take a goddamn auger to it and just freaking do my own weight relief, and which wouldn't be such a bad idea, because then I'd just cap the back, you know, with some kind of veneer or whatever. And then that'll be the end of that. And I still might do that. I mean, I gotta go get myself a set of augers to do it. To definitely do it. I'll get, like, you know, half inch auger, or 3/8 auger on up to like a 1 inch or inch and a quarter. Just so I can get everything cut correctly, because there's a pattern. You can take a look at weight relief on Google Images, and they'll show you that there is a pattern. So you can take that pattern, you can start tracing it out along the back, you know, and then make your holes. And then what you do is basically you have everything off. So you take a veneer, and then you put a veneer over it, and then you cap it. And so you've instantly, you know, you're not going to do anything to the freaking tone, really. Everything in the tone is, like, right here. The neck. Freaking neck, man. So, But this is your tone right here. You know, anything outside of that is just, you know, nominal. But it's all your hardware and all of that crap. And then you are a huge freaking factor in the tone. Fingers alone, a huge factor. I've seen guys who are really good. They pick up a shit guitar, they make that bitch sing. You got a guy who's a newbie, grabs a freaking $1,000, freaking $2,000, $4,000 guitar, picks that goddamn thing up. He can't make that damn thing sing for shit. It sounds like fucking crap. You know, and I'm probably that guy, you know. I'll pick up that $2,000, $3,000 guitar, and I'll be like, eh? Everybody's in the store going, oh God, I hope he leaves soon. And so I started this out just freaking bullshitting, and I'm just bullshitting some more. And thank you for keeping me company for a bit. I just had to play. It's like freaking goofing around. So anyway, I'm over. I'm way over, man. And I'm like freaking getting too comfortable with this. All right, people. Have a good one. Later. Peace.